I heard the Lord say, you tell my people, amen, to let us return to the Lord. Thanks to God. That's the thought that the Holy Ghost began to put into my spirit, amen, early this morning here at the church, amen, that there's a need for you and I, for the body of the Lord Jesus Christ, to return to him like never before. God's all right in me. You can have your Bible. If you turn with me, please, to the book of Hosea, chapter 6, and verse 1 and verse 3 is the scripture that we want to lay this, amen, our foundation from. We want to use these verses of scripture. Saints, we're living in a time, amen, where I can see how the Lord, amen, by his spirit begin to deal with me this morning, amen, about this. And you know, I didn't try to, amen, wiggle out of this or say, Holy Ghost, I'm not prepared, but amen, I know, amen, that the Holy Ghost will bring back to my remembrance all the things, amen, that he taught me through the years. He's all right in me.
All right.
But in the book of Hosea, saints of God, chapter 6, and verse 1 down to verse 3, it reads and said, remember our thought this morning, amen, let us return to the Lord. See, somebody this morning, amen, you don't want to look too far, amen, away from your God. He's all right in me. But the Lord is asking you to return. And I believe this is a personal call to me. And I begin to cry to the Lord and say, Lord, amen, where do I need to return to you in my own life? Not talking about you, but me. God's all right in me.
All right.
Amen. But then as I begin to look into the scripture, and as the Holy Ghost begin to deal with me and things begin to come together, and we begin to put it down on paper as the Holy Ghost begin to lead us this morning. And we begin to read the scripture from Hosea chapter 6 and verse 1 and 3. He said, come and let us return unto the Lord. He's all right, isn't he? You may think you've already returned, but you haven't. You haven't. You still, amen, living in 2020. God's all right, isn't he? For he had torn and he will heal us. Praise the Lord, everybody. He has smitten, amen, and he will bind us up. After 2 days will he revive us. In the third day, he will raise us up. Amen. And we shall live in his sight. Then shall we know, if we follow on to know the Lord, his going forth is prepared as the morning. Amen. And he shall come unto us. He's going to come unto you. Make it personal. He shall come unto me, amen, as the rain, and as the latter and the former rain upon the earth. In other words, the last, amen, that's about to be, amen, that latter rain we talked about so much, the outpouring of the Holy Ghost. He's all right, isn't he? The latter and the former rain will flow together.
Amen.
Saints of God, I hear the Lord said to me, this morning by his spirit, amen, said it, amen, speak to his people and ask them, amen, if they would return to him. Somebody this morning, amen, you're drifting away from your God. You're not in the place that you used to be in your relationship with your God. God wants you to know this morning, amen, that he loved the world and everybody in it. Remember, the Bible said, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believe in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent his son in the world, not to condemn the world, but that by and through him, that the world might be saved. He's all right, isn't he? Remember, saints of God, and to you that are with us this morning, amen. The Lord is asking us to return back, amen, to the place and our relationship with him. Remember, God loved the world and everything that is in it. Therefore, saints of God, he wants us to repent. I'm talking about the church. He's asking for us to repent of our sin and to return to him. You must look at this in your own personal life. You know the sin or the wrong that you might be doing in the sight of your God. He said, repent and return unto him. Remember, saints of God, amen. He longs, amen, for us, amen, to know him, amen, and to establish a personal relationship with him like never before. Remember, saints of God, that God longs, amen, for us to trust him, obey, amen, his holy commandments, amen, in the all right. And he's asking for you and I, amen, that we would trust, amen, in him like never before, and that we begin to live the life that we once lived in his presence and before him and before a dying world.
Yes.
Saints of God, once we trust, amen, hallelujah, once I want you to remember, amen, in all personal life, once you and I, we truly trusted the Lord, amen, he, amen, and when we trust him, he was able to bless us richly, and he's asking us to trust him again in the all right, looking out the saints of God and taking care of us. That's what the Lord wants to do. He's all right in me. I want you to know this morning, amen, that he can strengthen us. Amen. We face all the horrible trials and temptations of life that we find ourselves dealing with today. But we must return to the Lord if the Lord is going to fight our battle. First, saints of God, and to you that are with us this morning, amen. The people of Israel, saints of God, they was like, amen, us today, amen, a nation that is torn apart. Amen. This is when the prophet began to write, and we found ourselves in the same predicament today, a country, amen, saints of God, critically, amen, injured, amen, and in deep spiritual and need deep spiritual healing. Amen. I want you to know, saints of God, amen, a picture that is painted, amen, when the prophet began to make his comment, amen, about the time, amen, and what Israel was doing with, amen, and going through at that time. And we found ourselves in that same time today, amen, during that time, amen, when the prophet was asking them, amen, being led by the Spirit of God, that they return unto the Lord, there was lawlessness. And we see lawlessness, amen, in our nation and all around our states, our cities, our providence, amen, in the world today. We see violence on every hand, and not only that, immorality, amen, was running rampant, amen, throughout the nation of Israel, and the same in our nation today. Come and let us return unto the Lord, nearly saints of God, all the people, the rulers, amen, the citizens, amen, and every religious leader, amen, was consumed by a spirit, amen, of covetousness, amen, and we see that same spirit operating in the church today, amen, a spirit of pride, God's all right in me, amen, a spirit of covetousness, but God is asking his people to come, amen, and return back to him, he's all right in me. Amen. Our rulers, amen, and all the citizens, and even our religious leaders, amen, the politicians, and you name it, are consumed, amen, with this spirit I call covetousness. Amen. They trust, amen, saints of God, in other words, treating people, amen, unfairly. You can see it happening in our world and in our nation. Amen. Cheating and stealing. Politicians lying. Y'all don't hear me. Preachers even lying too. Amen. And stealing. Amen. Y'all don't hear me this morning, saints of God. Whenever and wherever they could. God's all right in me. You see, in that day, the people was guilty, amen, of prejudice, amen, and my God, he's all right in me, and we can see some of the same things happening today, discrimination, this is what Israel was going through and dealing with, they was guilty, amen, of building an unjust, amen, society, amen, oppressive, abusive, amen, society. God's all right in me. And we can see the same in the world today. God's all right in me. But he's asking his people to return, amen, unto him. The saints of God, amen. God, amen, was left with no choice when he came to Israel during this time. He was forced, amen, to begin executing judgment against them. Amen. And judgment is coming to our nation. Amen, and to the churches, amen, and to the leadership, amen, starting in the pulpit and working its way down. Come, let us return unto the Lord. Let us put aside our prejudice. Let us put aside our unjust, amen, and abusive society that we now live in. God has no other choice but to judge us like he judged him. He's all right, isn't he all right? Come and let us return unto our God. In the beginning stage, saints of God, amen, of the judgment of the Lord, amen, he gave the peoples up to their sins, amen, and they begin to reap, amen, what they had already sown. And we can see the same happening in the church world today. Amen. And in our society, we're reaping what we're sowing. He's all right in me. The nation of Israel at that time was being torn apart, amen, by the corruption, amen, of the political leaders, amen, and sin, amen, flowing out of the people's heart. And we see the same today, amen, our nation, amen, is being destroyed because of all the corruption, amen, of leadership. Y'all don't hear me? And all the hardness that is in the heart, God's all right in me. Their sinful behavior, amen, resulted in destruction, amen, of a nation. God's all right in me. We can see the same thing today, amen, happening in our nation. God's all right in me. The church, we must return, amen, back to our God like never before. In the all right, we got to turn away from politics. Y'all don't hear me? We got to get back, amen, to trusting our God, not trusting in a president. I don't think you hear me. I understand, amen, their position, their leadership, amen, of a nation. But my hope is not in Biden, and my hope was not in Trump. My hope was in the Lord. I said, like David said, I wait on the Lord, and my soul do hope. And in his word, amen, I trust. God's all right in me. Come and let us return unto the Lord. Amen. God's people got wrapped up and tied up, amen, politics. Y'all don't hear me. Became religious politician Christians. Amen. God's all right in me. And he told us not to get too entangled in the affairs of this life. God, people have been deceived, listening to prophet and prophetess. Amen, saints of God. Amen, over God, the internet, and YouTube, that are not even submitting themselves to nobody and no authority, and trying to operate as a prophet on the Old Testament covenant, and not understanding the New Testament prophetic covenant. God's all right in me. We got to return back to the Lord. He's all right in me. He's all right in me. God, people, have gotten stirred up, wrapped up and tied up and tangled up in a world system, falling in love with the world and the things of the world. Y'all don't hear me. Come and let us return back to the Lord in our relationship, in our meditation, in our love, in our devotion. He's all right in me. You know where you're at today in your relationship with your God. You know if you need to return or not. But I believe this morning, as the Holy Ghost began to deal with me and said you would not preach the message that you've been working on all this week, God's all right in me. He said, tell my people to return unto him. You got to turn away from Trump, amen, my Christian brothers. You got to turn away from Biden. Respect them. Give them their dues, amen, in the position they hold. But they're not God. They're not our Lord Jesus Christ. We got to return, amen, unto our Lord God. He's all right in me. We got to remember this world. It's not our home. We are pilgrims passing through. He's all right. He told us to occupy until he come. God's all right in me. The nation of Israel was being torn apart by the corruption, amen, that flowed in the heart of leadership. And we see it today, the Republican fighting the Democrats fighting the Republicans, amen, the independents fighting both. Y'all don't hear me? Lying on both sides. Now got God people, preachers calling God people, amen, names, saying they didn't pray enough. That's why Trump lost. You gotta take your own blame because your prophecy didn't come to pass. You thought God was leading you. Now you're gonna blame the saints of the Most High God. Y'all don't hear me this morning. We got to return, amen, unto the Lord. We got to return, amen, to the word of God. He's all right in me. He's all right in me. Yeah, saints of God, the sinful behavior and the results, amen, and destroying a nation because of his sin and his hard heart and his leadership, amen, torn apart. Y'all don't hear me. A house divided cannot stand. He's all right in me. There was only one hope, saints of God, and there is only one hope for the people today. There's only one hope for you today. There's only one hope for me today. God's all right in me. And that hope is nobody but Jesus. He's all right in me. The great I am. Amen. The bread that came down from heaven, that living water, the one that said, I am. God's all right in me. I'm here to tell somebody, you must repent, church. Church, you better listen to me this morning. We got to repent. We got to repent. We put too much trust in politics in 2020. Repent, repent. God's all right in me. Therefore, saints of God, Hosea called upon the people, amen, to turn away from their sin and back to the Lord. That's what God has placed in my heart this morning, to ask you, amen, and myself, amen, to turn from our sins and let us turn back to the Lord. Turn away from our ways. Turn away from our own feelings. What we desire, what we want to do, and how we want to do it. And let us return to the ways of the Lord. If the people would repent, God's all right in me. Back then and today, If we would repent today, they would, thanks of God, amen, take comfort in the wonderful facts and knowing that the Lord would restore, amen, them like he said he would. In verse 2, he would save the people and their nation, and he would do it quickly, within 2 to 3 days. That's what he said in his word. God's all right in me. The reference to 2 to 3 days simply means that the Lord would do it in a pretty quick period of time. My point is this, being stressed, saints of God, amen, and the fact that God will quickly accept, amen, and restore his people, amen, when they repent from their sin in the aura. Why would he do it? So that they might live, amen, in his presence. That's why he'll do it for us today, that you and I might live, amen, in his presence. I'm talking about a holiness. God, thanks of God alone, he's all right in me. Listen here, hallelujah, forever and ever. The sons and daughters, saints of God, he want us in his presence. He want us in fellowship with him. He want us to worship him. He want us to serve. Amen. Bearing strong testimony. Amen. Of his name like never before. Come and let us return unto the Lord. He's all right in me. We can't turn to the government. We got to return, amen, to God. God's all right in our saints of God. When a believer, amen, true sin, I'm going to tell him that the Lord will accept. Amen, and restore him or her. God's all right in me. Saints of God. In verse 3, Hosea challenged the people, amen, to diligently seek to know the Lord. I'm telling you this morning, as the Holy Ghost began to lead me early this morning about this message, he challenged the people. I'm challenging you, hallelujah, this morning, amen, to know the Lord, amen, needs to know him, amen, personally. Somebody, you need to know him personally, amen, to have a personal, amen, relationship with him. Amen, a person who truly know the Lord, walks in fellowship with him. Throughout the day, saints of God, that person walks in prayer, meditate upon God's holy word, and obey his commandments, living righteously, amen, and bearing a testimony, amen, of the Lord. He's all right in me. He's all right in me. It was this kind of life, this kind of daily walk, that the people of Israel should have been living. But saints of God, they was failing miserably, just like the church today. God's all right in me. Hosea challenged them, amen, to diligently seek to know the Lord. Is there anybody this morning, you need to seek, amen, diligently, amen, to know the Lord. If you know him and are falling short, come and let us return unto the Lord. He's all right in me. If they would seek after, amen, and return to the Lord, the Bible said he would respond, amen, to the seeker. As surely as the sun rises, the Lord would turn back to the individual, amen, accepting them. He would refresh them and meet the needs, amen, of them. Like rain that water the earth, the individual In other words, the Lord will meet the need of the individual saints of God who truly repent and turn back to him. Come and let us return unto the Lord. Time is running out, saints. He's all right, isn't he? We living in a wicked time. We living in a time where man is putting trust in man, putting trust, amen, in organization, putting trust, amen, lifting up prophets, amen, higher than Jesus. Y'all don't hear me. Elevating man, elevating positions, elevating church. God's all right in me. Elevating denominations. I'm going to tell you it's time for us to return unto the Lord. We got to get back to holiness. He's all right in me. Lord, refresh us here at Universal Faith. Refresh the pastor, Lord. Refresh the saints, Lord. Refresh your people in New Bern, North Carolina. God's all right in me. Come and let us return unto the Lord. You know your ways. You know how you're acting. You know how you're talking. You know where you're going. You know what you're doing. You know what ain't right in the sight of God. You better stop it. It's time to return unto the Lord. Hallelujah. I heard about 7 o'clock this morning telling me to preach this message to tell his people to return unto him. Isn't he all right? Isn't he all right? There are signs that we need, amen, to know that it's time to return. When you find yourself neglecting, amen, ignoring God's word, you don't want to hear what the word has to say. You ignore the word. You ignore Bible study. You ignore Sunday morning service. You ignore reading your word. You ignore studying your word. There's a sign that you need to return. Saints of God, when we harbor hidden sin, amen, from our past, it's time to return to the Lord. Amen. When we neglect, amen, our responsibility and telling somebody about Jesus, it's time to return unto the Lord. When we decide, amen, to deliberately disobey God, I'm just not going to do it his way. I don't care. He understands. Y'all don't hear me. It's time to return unto the Lord. When we run from our calling, our anointing, what God is speaking in our heart, amen, to do, where to go, how to do it. It's time, amen, to return unto the Lord. When we find ourselves, amen, disgraceful, disregarding God connection all together, don't want to hear what he got to say, you know it's time to return unto the Lord. Somebody, on the sound of my voice, I hear the Lord saying, return unto him, my brother, my sister. You know what you're doing. You know what you're saying. You know how you're acting. You know what's in your heart. You know your attitude. You know where your trust is at. You know where your faith is at. You know where your hope is at. Return unto the Lord. I heard, amen, I'm right in the book of Acts, chapter 3 and 19. He said, repent therefore and be converted, that your sin may be blotted out. when the time of refreshing, amen, shall come from the presence of the Lord. There's a time of refreshing, amen, that is coming. I'm talking about the outpouring, the second outpouring of the Holy Ghost. That's why I believe God, by his spirit, has had me teaching and preaching about holiness and about the wine, the Holy Ghost, and about the helper, the Holy Ghost. Come and let us return unto the Lord. The Bible said in Acts 8:22, repent ye therefore of this thy wickedness and pray God, amen, if perhaps, amen, through, amen, the thoughts of thine heart may be forgiven thee. My Bible tells me in the book of 2 Chronicles 7:14, we all quote it, if my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and I will forgive their sin and will heal their land. Come, saints of God, and let us return unto the Lord. Let us repent of our sins, of our shortcoming, of our idleness, of our wrong that we've done in the sight of our God. Come and let us return unto our God. My Bible tells me in Isaiah 55:6-7, y'all don't hear me. It says, seek the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he is now. Y'all don't hear me. It's time to seek the Lord while he can be found. Call upon him like never before. Come and let us return unto the Lord. And verse 7 says in these scriptures, let the wicked forsake his ways and the unrighteous man his thoughts, and let him return unto the Lord. He's all right. You better forsake your ways. You better return unto the Lord in your thoughts, in your attitude. You better return unto the Lord. He's all right in me, and he will have mercy upon him, the scripture said, and to our God, for he will abundantly, amen, pardon. He's all right in me. In the all right, to seek the Lord simply means to look for, amen, to seek for, to inquire about, to investigate, to pursue, to strive after, saints of God. It also means, amen, to plead and to cry for something, amen, to the point, amen, of struggling. Only a person who is sensing a deep, amen, need will seek the Lord with such urgency, saints of God. That's the time we're in right now. This is an urgent time for you and I to seek the Lord in the aura. We got to pursue after, we got to strive after, we got, saints of God, we got to plead, we got to cry out like never before. God's all right in me. And this is exactly, saints of God, the objective that God is looking for from you and I. He's all right in me. There is, saints of God, an urgent need for every human being, amen, to seek the Lord and return back to our first love. God's all right in me. We got to return. Universal Faith Church, when we return to our building, I believe, hallelujah, in June, we'll be in full force. Hallelujah. When we return, We got to first make sure that in our homes now, we got to return to the Lord, that when we come together again as a corporate body, God's all right in me, that the Holy Ghost, amen, will move in this place. God's all right in me. There's a second invitation in Isaiah 55, verse 6 and 7. Amen. And that is this. There is a warning that was given in the scriptures. He's all right in it. People can wait too long. Don't wait too long, my brother. Don't wait too long, my sister. It's time to return. If God dealt with me this moment, then it's time right now. I don't know how much time. I don't know how long grace will abide upon this, but it's time to return unto the Lord. He's all right in me. They fail to seek the Lord while he is near. Amen. And still can be found. Saints of God, opportunities are not always available. Amen. And seeking the Lord throughout our day, saints of God. Many of us in our minds, we have to be focused upon our jobs and duties. And other things we find ourselves, amen, wrapped up in. Amen. He's all right in me. Great opportunity to seek the Lord is in a quiet time in our home, early, late at night, early in the morning, sitting in the church. God don't hear me this morning. He's all right in me. It is saints of God. It is time for us to get back in the presence of our God. Let us return, Universal Faith Church, and to you that are out there. Let us return. Let us return. You might want to say to yourself, I'm going to return back to my relationship. I'm going to return back to my fasting, back to my praying. I'm going to return back to my love, back to my meekness, back to my temperance, back to my long suffering. I'm going to return back to the gifts. I'm about to return back to my God. Let us return. Returning to the Lord, amen, is necessary because of his wrath against all sin. Returning to the Lord is necessary. Hallelujah. Because, saints of God, when you return, it opened up the supply line, amen, of his grace. Returning to the Lord is what, saints of God, amen, we should learn from the history of God's people. I'm talking about Israel. He's all right. Saints of God, and you that are here this morning, it's time to return. It's time to return. Don't put off for tomorrow. Don't put off for next week. Don't put off for next month. Don't put off for the next hour. Return to the Lord. Apostle Thomas, how can I return? Hallelujah. Accept your personal responsibility for your own sin. You know the sins that you've been committed. You know the sin in your life that is not right before your God. This is how you return. Make an honest confession. Be honest first with yourself and then with your God. He's all right in it. I'm taking on that responsibility, Lord, of my sin, my shortcoming, Father, my idleness, Father, my wrong, Father, that I have done in this body, conscious of and not conscious of. Oh, God, I confess today my wrong, Lord. I'm honest this day before you. Oh, God, And to you that are with us this morning, how can we return to the Lord? We got to renounce every false god that have came in our life during this corona. Many gods have been added to our lives. We've sat at home meditating on other things than the word of God. We've committed ourselves. We've given vows and commitment, amen, to other things, putting them ahead of our God. Y'all don't hear me? We've committed to committees, organizations, amen, associations. Y'all don't hear me? God's all right in me. We put these things above our salvation, our relationship with our God. It's time to return and renounce these gods that's before us. He's all right in me. To return, you got to claim God promises to restore you. Oh God, I claim that promise today. The Lord will restore me. I'm returning to him. I'm repenting of my sin, my shortcoming, my idleness, my wrong. The Lord will restore me. He's all right in me. The Lord has promised if I repent, he'll forgive me. If I confess, he'll forgive me. The Lord in the all right. If I return, he'll raise me up in 3 days. Y'all don't hear me. God's all right in me. You got to surrender your will, amen, to the Lord. Come and let us return unto the Lord. Come and let us return unto the Lord. I got to return, amen, to my God, in my meditation, in my prayer, in my fasting, in my devotion. Y'all don't hear me? In my trust, in my hope, in my aspiration. God, help me, Holy Ghost. Help me, Holy Ghost. Help me, Holy Ghost. Amen. To return unto my God. Help me, Holy Ghost. Help the saints of the Most High under the sound of my voice, that they may return to their God. He's all right in not just city God. I'm talking about the Lord, amen, Jesus Christ. I'm talking about the one, amen, who came and said he was in the world and the world was made by him. I'm talking about the one that said great in the all right, saints of God, without controversy, great in the midst of godliness, for God, hallelujah, walked on the earth, seen of angels, preached to the Gentiles, gone back to glory, in the all right, in the all right. I'm talking about the one that came down through 42 generations, hung on Calvary cross for my sin and your sin, in the all right. I'm talking about the lily of the valley, the bright and morning star. I'm talking about the wheel in the middle of a wheel. I'm talking about the rock huge out of a mountain, in the all right. I'm talking about the bread that came down, amen, from heaven. I'm talking about the one that said, I am, in the all right. Jesus, 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 that's his name. Come and let us return unto the Lord. Father, this morning we pray for the saints and those that are with us. We pray that they may return to you. Father, you, amen, instructed me by your spirit this morning, change the entire message, that your people will return to you, because what is about to take place and all that's coming upon this earth, whoo, I pray for them right now, Father. I pray for their homes, their families, their communities, their jobs, I pray for them personally. They're coming in, they're going out. They may return to you in their philosophy, their way of thinking, their precepts, their concept. Oh God, I pray for your people, Lord, that their trust be put in the proper place, not in politicians, that will continue to lie, fight among each other. Oh God, oh God, I pray for your people. In Jesus' mighty name. This is Apostle Thomas, pastor of Universal Faith Church, located at 914 West Street. Thank God for the musicians, Thomas, myself. Thank God for it. You want to say if you want to be a blessing to the ministry? Amen. You can bless us. Send a donation. Amen. Our Cash App, Universal Faith Church, or to our PayPal, UniversalFaithChurch20@gmail.com. Thank God for you this morning. And remember the message. Come. And let us return unto the Lord. Remember, you can also go on YouTube. Amen. Apostle Darrell Thomas Sr. Look at our teachings and whatever there. Amen. We hope to see you Wednesday night as we talk about, once again, holiness. God bless you. Have a great day. Come. Let us return unto the Lord. God bless you, church. Bye-bye.